We're oceanographers in this lab. In particular, we study ocean chemistry. Now, this project that we're working on here is not in the oceans. It's in the largest liquid freshwater environment on the planet, that being the Great Lakes system. And what better place to do that research than at the University of Rochester, which is so close to Lake Ontario. For the greenhouse gases that humans have an impact on, the one that we hear so much about is carbon dioxide, but also one that humans have a significant influence on is methane. It has the second largest warming influence. The oceans cover about 70% of the surface of the planet, yet they're a relatively minor source of certain greenhouse gases to the atmosphere. Yet freshwater environments are really screaming hot sources of methane outgassing to the atmosphere. Now, the surprising thing to us is the Great Lakes system, which is this massive body of liquid fresh water. There's been very, very few methane measurements throughout. We've been traveling out onto Lake Ontario to conduct this research. We've also had a few opportunities to go out on Lake Michigan and Lake Superior. And when we go out on these research vessels, our goal is to collect as much data as possible. And we can do that in a variety of ways. The traditional way of doing it is just to simply take a vial of water, something like this, fill this up with lake water, and bring it back to the laboratory for analysis. So we've been developing some new techniques as well that will continually pump up water as our research vessel is transiting from one point to another. So instead of walking off the boat, say, with a cooler of 100 vials of water like this, we walk off with a laptop with about 10,000 measurements. The highest concentrations we saw were in the coastal environments, and it was like 200 parts per million. There's some analyses that are just simply too sophisticated for us to do on a rocking research vessel. And so we need to bring some water back to the laboratory to do those more sophisticated analyses. Ultimately, my goal in this project is to establish a research program across the entire Great Lakes system. That requires two things. Number one, we need to establish the technology that can enable us to collect the samples we need. We're developing it here at the U of R in our laboratories, and we're taking it out on the lake to test it, to see what works, what doesn't work. And number two, we need a strong fundamental data set of greenhouse gas distributions and dynamics throughout the Great Lakes system that then we can build upon to ask more focused questions about what controls this environment.